So the topic consists of contracting. Contracting consists of the legal, commercial, and taxation part. The second one is the automation, and third one is the engineering, and fourth one the what the challenges the EPC player today is getting right. So now I'm just focus about the basic things. Our ambition to achieve 175 gigawatt. Out of that, 100 gigawatt is a utility and 40 gigawatt, 60 gigawatt is utility and 40 gigawatt. You have the rooftop system. Now the government is opening the tender, going in the bill in a smooth manner, but there are a lot of challenges is happening. Due to that, the developer is not interested at all to participate in the bid. Like the anti-damping, safeguard duty, GST and other parameter still is not clear. Even our the rooftop and utility system of the draft policy is not finalized from the MNRE or from the DISCOM or from the standard policy. So this needs to be captured into the account. So now coming into the contracting part, how contracting is important while implementing with the other party like the EPC player or the manufacturer or the developer. The contracted consists of enforceable binding or mutually agreed between the two parties. Either it is a written document or it is a verbal document, but verbal is not enforceable in Indian constituency because our law does not allow of that one. But when you are talking about the contracting, that means your scope should be very, very clear. What the developer, what the EPC player, what the O&M guys is mentioning, it should be very, very clear. Otherwise, in the latter stage, they will debate part by part. In the case of the commercial also, the commercial, how play the bigger role in the commercial? Because you are doing the procurement. Before doing the procurement, you have to make the specs, float the RFQ, go for the TV technical bid evaluation, go for the commercial bid evaluation. If both the parties are agree, then you have to sign the contract. Now coming into the evaluation of the technology, definitely I think Puneet has talked about the IT segment and the automation segment coming very much going to play a role in the solar segment. Today you can see the incremental difference in your module inverter and tracker also. I think Suresh has already presented. Somebody is claiming it will go maybe 12%, 13% of higher when you are using the tracker. Somebody is saying it is a 25% also. It depends upon the technology. But you also keep in mind that when you are using the fixed tilt versus the tracker, what is the cost benefit analysis happening? Which technology you are using? When module has gone up from 280 watt peak, 244 watt peak to 370 and 400 watt peak, the efficiency has also gone up like that, and the price reduction is happening. So definitely there is a innovation in the equipment side. Similar case, the inverter is also gone from 300 kilowatt to 1500 VDC. Even the string inverter has also come up in a very big way. So you can monitor directly through a string rather than the zone monitoring. So better you can monitor and perform your the plant. But overall, what is happening, what is required today? Because everything has happened. 3 busbar to 5 busbar has happened in the module. Multi-busbar has happened in the module. Inverter has happened from a string to central for 300 kilowatt for 3.12 megawatt. Now the innovation is required in the two segment. The segment is the optimization of the designing optimization and the operation side. Because in India there is a very, not only India, in the globally, there is a water consumption, water scarcity is huge. Even you have the water, but you don't have the good quality of water. There is a lot of TDS, other contaminant is required. So when you are going to clean off the water through the RO system or the EDR system, again the government will not permit to reject rejection of the water. You can directly throw into the sea and river. It is not also permissible if your TDS is very, very high. So what you have to come up? You have come up with the dry cleaning system where water is not required. Why we are saying the dry cleaning system? You are saying the green energy. Where is the green energy you are consuming? One module is consuming 2 liter of water, and suppose 1 megawatt consists of at least 3,300 numbers of module. How much kilowatt or how much liter water is consumed of cleaning of the module? Because India is very dusty. In the Rajasthan segment, I mean the sandy area is also also there, right? So you cannot clean each and every day. Otherwise, your PLF will drop and the performance will be decreased significantly. So better you have to go for the dry cleaning system. There are a lot of manufacturers. Automation system is also played very big role in the security system, bounding wall, fencing, because there is a theft problem and other things is also. When you are doing the optimization and designing, a lot of your STAT project required, shadow analysis is required, in your transmission are also different load flow analysis is required. What you have to do, you have to make the automation, make the prototype, do the IT engineering within the range, and then you have to praise the rule, because initially it was required 5 acres of land, now it is required only for 3 acres of the land. How you are going to optimize of the design with the quality and timeline? So it's all the optimization totally. When you are using the optimization, what happened? The resources, you are not depend upon the totally on the dependence of the resources. Because when you are putting 100 megawatt of, suppose putting 100 megawatt of the plant, at least 300 to 400 crore is required for investment. And your non-skilled labor is going and cleaning of the module. Do you think when you are buying the gold for only for some of the 10 mg or something like that, when you are not allowing to touch anybody, but putting 500 crore of the investment, 1,000 crore of investment, non-skilled person is going, they are going and cleaning like anything, they are putting pressure, they will damage your module, and then you are allowing all this stuff. So we have to think in the future perspective, what is happening, what is the demand is required from the outside world, from the customer side, from the developer side, from the utility side, from the government side, all these things is required. Other parameter is also required, that is your integration in the rural area. The integration is required only for the digital India, and then you go for the rural electrification where the villages, they don't have, you know, transmission line, but you have to put on their roof, at least they have the roof for 1 kilowatt or 2 kilowatt, they can run at least 2 fan, 1 bulb also, they can survive, because most of the villages, 70% in our population is a rural area, and that they are not getting sufficient electricity today. So we have to think about the digitization and other integration part of that one to supply the surplus amount of electricity. What is the challenges today we are getting in the Indian market as a developer? Because we have the very tedious approval process. Very tedious permit and approval process, either it is a land acquisition or in the transmission line or in the evacuation system. It is a very, very tedious, because we don't have any driven policies. We don't have any driven policies for the rooftop, either utility or rooftop or in the storage system. So this should be also keep into mind when government is announcing some policy or giving the target for that one. So this is my humble submission from the government. They have to give the clear cut policy to the developer. That's the, otherwise we cannot get the investor. Outside funding, they are already going to a stop, and we will get a stop while this type of tariff, we don't have the clear cut of the policy. I am shortcutting my this speech. Thank you very much.